Fertilizers are one of the single largest variable cropping costs in the southern grain growing region. So when growers and their advisors were not seeing the improved crop yields they expected, their concern resulted in some action. As part of GRDC's More Profit from Crop Nutrition initiative, research into plant-available phosphorus was undertaken.
We'd often see a vegetative growth response to applied phosphorus fertiliser early in the growing season, but as we came to grain harvest, there was no actual grain yield response to that fertiliser, and therefore potentially the growers had lost their investment in terms of fertiliser.
Of the total pool of phosphorus in soil, only a small percentage is present in plant-available form. Most of it is tied up in slow-release mineral or organic compounds. So fertilisers are applied to boost levels of plant-available P for the developing young crops.
Not all phosphorus fertiliser is taken up by the young plants. As their roots move deeper, the unused P gets left behind, either left in the topsoil, where a lack of soil moisture limits the ability of the maturing crop's roots to access it, or fixed, meaning it's chemically unavailable.
Soil testing is the standard mechanism used to determine phosphorus levels, and in the southern region, particularly the Wimmera and Mallee, the Colwell P test has been widely used. So here at DEPI's Horsham Research Facility, a traceable radioactive isotope of phosphorus, P33, was watered into potted plants to quantify what the soil test was detecting.
One of the hypotheses we had initially was those crops were accessing sources of phosphorus in the soil, potentially mineral, maybe organic phosphorus pools that the soil test wasn't detecting, but the crop could access itself and therefore meant the crop wasn't responding to phosphorus fertiliser applications.
A phosphorus soil test developed by the University of Adelaide, the DGTP test, was also used with apparent success.
Recent research undertaken using P isotopes indicates that DGT better reflects the P pool in soil accessed by wheat plants than other commonly used soil tests such as Colwell. This research may explain why field data collected in southeastern Australia by Sean Mason and farmer groups over the past few years suggests that the DGT test better predicts P fertiliser response than Colwell, especially on highly alkaline calcareous soils.
Whether the same conclusion can be made for non-alkaline soils is open for debate. Another contributor to the phosphorus pool comes from what's on top of the soil, and research by a GRDC-funded PhD student provided a significant insight.
Sarah Nurek with University of Adelaide, she focused on looking at the availability of phosphorus in crop residues and what impact that had on the phosphorus cycle. What Sarah found was there's a small but significant amount of phosphorus remaining in plant residues at grain maturity, but what Sarah's work found using NMR was, you know, the popular conception was most of that phosphorus was organic. She actually demonstrated it was inorganic in nature, so that phosphorus was easily leached out if you had a reasonable size, you know, 20 mil rainfall event after maturity, and that inorganic phosphorus would drop to the ground and be potentially available to plants or microbial uptake.
Field trials in South Australia and Victoria followed the glasshouse work and focused on the impact environmental factors, especially rainfall and soil water, had on phosphorus availability to crops.
What was found was that crops only source 5 to 25% of their total phosphorus uptake from fertilisers. The remainder comes from background soil-available phosphorus. So the P fertiliser effectively stimulates the uptake of background soil P rather than meeting the crop's phosphorus requirements itself.
Those field results were groundbreaking as they led to a better understanding of the impact environmental factors have on a crop's response to phosphorus.
And the really important thing that came out of that was nitrogen nutrition was essential to determining your likelihood of a response to phosphorus. So it didn't necessarily reverse the other way, but if you wanted to maximise grain yield, response to applied phosphorus, you had to get your nitrogen nutrition right.
As southern region growers prepare for the new season, they should consider what this research has shown and test for soil phosphorus. If the results of a specific test are in doubt, compare it with a different test, because knowing what's in your soil can potentially save you spending more on phosphorus fertilizer than necessary, or indicate when investing in additional P could result in improved yields.